Hello friends, I am NK Jain from skillontech.com and welcome you all on this channel to see a rotary twin screw compressor. How a rotary twin screw compressor works, how it functions, and what are its internal components. These rotary twin screw compressors are very widely used for industrial refrigeration, gas processing, and other service applications. So today we will learn and see a how done way. Rotary twin screw compressor. Howden is a world famous manufacturer of screw compressors. So let us see a demo how it functions. You can see in this picture, this is a casing of a rotary twin screw compressor. This technology of a screw compressor was developed in 1930 by a Swedish company. Inside of this casing, internal components of the screw compressors are installed. The casing of the compressor is made of cast iron, or it can be made of sphorodial graphite iron for special applications. The rotors of the screw compressor is made of carbon steel or special alloy steel. Inlet and outlet end covers are flanged end. These are made of flanged end because of easy removal of the flange end connection. These covers are bolted with casing and doweled with proper alignment. So if we make a flange end connection for inlet and outlet, then they can be removed whenever required for maintenance of the compressor. Now we'll see. This is a gas inlet port and one is a gas outlet port. Here you can see oil injection connection, female inlet and oil connection, and a super feed port. You can see a drive shaft which is connected with the motor or prime mover, which rotate these helical screw gears. This is a male outlet and bearing connection, and one is a male inlet and oil connection. The oil is injected in the screw compressor for providing lubrication to journal thrust bearings as well as to both the helical screws. During the operation of screws and compression of air or gas, heat is generated. So, this oil is also used to cool the helical screws. Now we can see the internal components of this screw compressor. You can see there are two helical gears, these. So one gear is driven by a prime mover or motor. Other gear, helical screw, is attached with the driving helical screw and get rotated. Inside of this there is thrust journal bearings. And mechanical oil seal is also provided to prevent the leakage of oil along the driving shaft. A balancing device, which is a piston, balancing piston, is also provided in the screw compressors to balance the axial thrust generated due to air or gas force, which act on the rotors in both the directions. Now you can see this is a rotor casing, slide wall assembly, discharge casing, or actuator piston. Now you can see a rotating screws, how they get rotated. This is a bearing housing. Here thrust bearings are installed. Thrust bearings are of generally white metal, and thrust pads are fixed to take axial load of the rotors. There are two helical screws. One is a male screw and other is a female screw. The male screw is called lobes and female screw is called flutes. These type of screw compressors are called positive displacement rotary design compressors. Now you can see thrust collars which are provided in the bearings. Here you can see a female screw and other one is a male screw. Now you can see male inlet and journal bearing and other one is a female inlet and journal bearing. These are the main components. Axial thrust which occur on the shaft due to high pressure which is developed by screws is taken care by thrust bearings, and a balancing piston of thrust is also inbuilt in the compressor. The high pressure or low pressure gas goes into the piston which balance the axial thrust force. The compression of the gas taken place due to trapping of air or gas while it comes from suction in between the both screws. All compressors take air suction through a air filter which is installed outside of the compressor. Now you can see assembly of two helical screws. Thrust bearings are installed. Now you can see a balancing piston. The high pressure or low pressure side gas goes into the piston and operate it to balance the thrust acting on each side of the bearings. Why it is so important? Because if thrust load increases on the bearings, that can cause to damage of bearings. Therefore, a accurate balancing of thrust load is essential to have a long life service of the compressor. You can see the position of the piston. Maximum capacity 100% wall position. Now you can see in this picture air is coming through suction and entering into the lobes. Due to converging space and a close tolerance between both the helical screws, the air is get compressed and a high pressure is developed, which is discharged through discharge flange of the compressor to oil separator, air oil separator. In the discharge of screw compressor, air oil separator is installed which separated air and oil. oil goes back to the casing of the compressor and air discharge air goes to the air receiver tank. These helical screws are very precisely machined and a close tolerance is maintained as per ISO standards to achieve the performance of the compressor. Now you can see how the helical screws are moving and air or gas which is sucked is discharged through the compressor. Here you can see the balancing piston device which also act to balance the thrust load. These compressors are very highly reliable, efficient and provide a long life. Now you can see oil flow into the bearings and the lobes. The bearings are force lubricated and oil is also sent to the lobes for cooling. And provide a sealing between the lobes. So air will not go back. The high pressure which is developed during the compression will not go back towards the low pressure side. You can see bearing and oil flows. The oil is going into the bearings and provide a proper lubrication to the bearing for a longer life. So Howden is a very renowned and famous manufacturer for these twin lobe compressors. This is all about Howden reciprocating screw compressor. Positive displacement compressors are widely used for refrigeration, gas processing and other service applications. And this rotary twin screw compressors are also used nowadays for these purposes. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below and share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.